Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Hey Fish family, welcome back to Tabarak Aquatics. I am Ross, and welcome to my fish room. Thank you very much. Well, first of all, before we begin, I want to say that I've noticed lately that I've been getting a lot of, for me it's a lot, but I've been getting more action on my channel. Thank you. I've been getting some more subscribers, and I've been getting comments, people commenting, and let me know what's on their mind and asking questions and give me their opinions. I want to thank you very much from the bottom of my heart. Thank you very much. I see you. Okay, those who are subscribing, I see you. Thank you. I appreciate that. I do notice that. I watch it because it's important to me. I want this channel to grow. Those of you who have questions and so forth, who make comments, thank you very much. As you can tell, I engage in conversation and questions as much as possible. I'm not a genius and I'm not an expert. I'm just sharing my hobby with you guys and sharing my experiences. All right, now that's over. If you are new to this channel and you have not subscribed, please subscribe. I do thank you for your activity. YouTube, they will see this activity. They will see the subscription, see the thumbs up, see the comments, and it would alert them to put this channel in front of other people like you who are interested in the aquarium hobby and my fish and me as a personality. All right, thank you very much. Anyway, moving right along, this evening we're gonna do a real short, I'm trying to make it short, I know I talk a lot, a short video about my albino heckli, sort of a profile, a species profile, so to speak, all right? My style. Hang tight, here we go. This is my tank with my albino thread friend hecklies, also called Arictis heckli. This is the albino version. Of course, in the wild, they don't naturally come like this. This is the albino version of them. Well, originally, that species, the thread friend Acara or the heckli cichlid, they come from the area of Colombia, Brazil, Peru, in those areas. And they come from a very murky tannings type of water that they come from. And they're very, they're most comfortable in very low pH, very acidic water, very, moderately warm temperature. They like the temperature somewhere around 76 to 82. 80 degrees were probably very comfortable for them. Very beautiful cichlid. They used to be, the albino version used to be very hard to get to, but they're becoming more readily available in the hobby. I'm thankful for that because I was able to get my hand on quite a few, as you can see. I have 9 of them in this tank. Okay, I started out with 10, but I had a polypterus that was a baby at the time, and they were babies, and I put them in there together, and the polypterus decided to practice his biting skills, and he wanted to try to eat one, and he killed it. So, but anyway, these 9 that I have in here, I raised them all together as very small little babies, little grow-outs, so to speak. They're still grow-outs because they're not really mature yet. But as you see, this, like this guy here, he's growing a little nuchahump. He got all the color and everything. So you can pretty much bet that that's the dominant male in this tank. Okay, I showed this tank before in the past, and I was talking about the fin nipping that was going on in my barbs. my filament barbs that I had in here. Was doing the fin nipping, and as you can see, their red trailers grew back really nicely. They are beautiful. Their red trailers just make them stand out. You know, that's why they call it thread fin, because of the little trailers that they have. But when you have the albino version, they look especially beautiful. As you can see, I got some other tank mates in here with these guys, but tonight we're going to focus on these guys here. Now, they're surprisingly very hardy fish. They're very hardy. Like I said, I started out with 10, only lost one due to the fact that a fish killed it because he tried to eat it. But other than that, they have survived some things that's been going on in his tank. Me moving from upstairs to downstairs, and changing his substrate, and I had a disease outbreak in this tank and lost some heavy hitters. I lost several plecos and so-called hardy catfish, but I did not lose these guys, not a one. They're very hardy, and I thank them for being hardy, because they were a tad bit on the expensive side, hard to get to, and I love them very much. Now, they are very peaceful cichlids. They are semi-aggressive, but more so on the peaceful side. They do spar with each other, and I was thinking about putting three more in here, but I was a little afraid that that they might just bully them for a little while, just to let them know what the hierarchy situation is in this tank. They, like I said, they like a pH of somewhere between 6 and 7.2. My water is usually at somewhere between 6.2, 6.4. It comes out the faucet, very, very acidic, low pH. These silverfish here, they are very jumpy, because what I did, I turned the lights off down here and turned this light on so that I could get a good showing of these guys, and not get so much glare and everything to turn. I just want this tank to look beautiful so you guys can appreciate it the way I appreciate it, try to show off their beauty as much as possible. I did buy a new camera, but I had trouble disabling the, I had to get an app for it and connect and do all this other stuff, and it just wasn't working out, so I'll figure it out tomorrow. But I didn't want to put off this video, because I do want to stay active, especially being that I have a few new subscribers. I don't want to disappoint. So if you plan on getting any of these threadfin albino, threadfin acara, or Erichthys heckeli, I'm going to tell you that make sure that it's a fairly peaceful tank. Make sure that you keep them in mind, as far as they got to be the centerpiece, pretty much. Oh, there's my sunshine pleco. This little guy stays out. He stays hanging out. He loves to be seen. Sorry, I got sidetracked. I'm just enjoying my tank, especially when I spend so much money on these little fish. But anyway, they have a varied diet. They are omnivores. They eat everything I put in here. I put in some Northfin veggie pellets. I also put in Hikari Vibra Bites, and occasionally I put in extreme krill flakes and stuff like that. But they eat everything I put in here. I just try to keep mindful that they like a varied diet, and if you put too much protein in there and feed them too much protein without any vegetables, what's going to happen is that they're going to get bloated and constipated, and it's going to cause some complications, some illnesses, which we don't want. Okay, I'm just showing you my my plecos down there fighting, and you gotta appreciate when the plecos come out. I gotta show them every time I get a chance. In any case, guys, I probably rambled on a little more than I should have. I'm gonna wrap this up. I just wanted to show off my albino hack line, okay? Thank you very much. And again, if you haven't subscribed, please subscribe to my channel. I greatly appreciate it. I appreciate all the support. Please give a thumbs up, you know, like this. And if you don't like it, you know, don't give me a thumbs down. Just leave me a message and let me know what I can do to improve on my content and everything. If you have any suggestions or if you have any requests, please just let me know. But I appreciate it if you subscribe. I'm trying to grow. If you like and leave comments, I appreciate all the activity that I can get, okay? Until next time, everybody, big ups. Big ups for coming to my channel. And assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.